We reviewed the Galaxy A50 recently and we were mighty impressed. It certainly does have a lot of features that other phones in the segment don't. Now, how about the Galaxy A20? Let's find out. It's here, let's unbox it and take a quick look. Design, gaming performance, camera samples and whatnot. Before we begin, let me introduce myself. My name is Ashwin Sundar. This is Technology Jock. Subscribe to the channel and more importantly, hit the bell icon for more videos. A huge shout out to Plato Science for sponsoring this video. They've got this uber cool product, Plato Work, which is the world's first consumer headset for boosting your cognition. It's not a gimmick, it actually helps you improve memory, creativity, focus and whatnot. It uses a popular neurostimulation technology to achieve it. The fact that it is available for consumers now is just amazing. You can take it literally anywhere you want. The headset runs on battery and it's very light. It's available on Indiegogo, it's already received a ton of funding. Do check it out if you want to buy one for yourself. Link is in the description. Now, this one's very similar to the A50's box. The unboxing experience is pretty much the same too. There's some paperwork including warranty card and SAR value information, the Galaxy A20 smartphone, a 15 watts adaptive fast charger, a USB Type-C cable, and a pair of traditional earphones, not the in-ear type. And finally, a SIM ejector pin. The A20 looks quite similar to the M20. It has a shiny look that might look like glass to some of you, but it's actually plastic. As you can see, it doesn't offer a gradient look or anything. It's just plain solid color with a little bit of shine. So while the design may not mimic a more expensive Samsung phone, it does seem to be quite functional because number one, it has a 3.5mm headphone jack and a USB Type-C port. Number two, the button placements are fine. They're clicky, they offer good feedback. Number three, for a 6.4 inch display phone, it is reasonably thin and light. It weighs under 170 grams, and thanks to the even weight distribution and curved edges, it feels really nice in hand. And just like on the M20, there's a rear fingerprint scanner, which is okay. Not as fast as a Redmi Note 7 scanner, but not too bad either. Now the front also looks quite similar to the M20, but there are two significant changes. The M20 has a Full HD Plus display, while the A20 has a 720p HD Plus display. But the A20 uses a superior Super AMOLED panel, while the M20 uses a TFT panel. I know, when you hear TFT, you go like, what? TFT? But guys, the TFT display on the M20 was quite good. I'm not saying it's as good as a Super AMOLED panel, but that 1080p TFT display is better than this 720p Super AMOLED display. In my opinion, of course. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section. For what it's worth, the phone has support for Widevine L1 certification, so you can watch Netflix and Amazon Prime videos in HD resolution. The display is quite large at 6.4 inches, and given that it's Super AMOLED panel, the colors, the contrast, and the viewing angles are amazing. The loudspeaker at the bottom is also decent, it gets quite loud. So overall, in terms of media consumption, this phone seems promising. Let's now jump inside the phone and take a look. The A20 is powered by Exynos 7884 chip. Well, where does this stand among the competition? Well, we saw the Exynos 7904 chip on the M20 and M30. The 7884 is slightly less powerful than the 7904. So don't expect it to handle big titles like PUBG and Asphalt, even in medium graphic settings. However, for day-to-day tasks like using social media, WhatsApp, watching videos on YouTube, streaming music, etc., this should get the job done. The base variant of the phone has 3GB RAM. All the recent Samsung budget phones that I used had great RAM management. So even with 3GB RAM, I expect the A20 to perform reasonably well. And yeah, the internal storage is just 32GB, but there is a dedicated micro SD card slot which supports up to 512GB storage. The battery capacity is again a downgrade from the M20, it's 4000mAh, but given there is a slightly slower processor and the presence of Super AMOLED display, which is really battery efficient, power efficient, there won't be a major difference in battery life. I will use the phone for a while and come up with a full review soon, so there I will be giving more battery stats. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to watch that one. One of the main selling points of A-series phones is the software. One UI based on Android 9 Pie, and the A20 also runs on it. We have a bunch of useful features like face unlock, motion gestures for enhanced user experience, and even Samsung Pay Mini. Now, back to the exterior, we missed something here. Yep, the cameras. At first, I really thought the secondary camera was a depth sensor, but I was quite surprised to learn that it's actually an ultra-wide-angle camera. Probably the same 5-megapixel sensor we saw on the M20. Decent performance under good lighting conditions. The main camera is a 13-megapixel sensor with f1.9 aperture, which can click some nice pictures under good and bad lighting conditions. And then there's an 8-megapixel selfie camera. The processing seems different from the M30 and A50. Those phones had excellent HDR performance for selfies, but this one doesn't. Not a big deal for a budget phone. The A20 costs 12,490 rupees. At that price, there are better options if you're looking for a good gaming phone or a good camera phone. But if you're looking for something different, something cool, something Samsung, because, you know, brand value, surveys and everything, people prefer Samsung for a lot of reasons, then the A20 has a few things to offer that other phones don't, like the Super AMOLED display, the ultra wide angle camera, and the dedicated micro SD card slot. What are your thoughts on this phone? Would you like to see a full review of this phone on Technology Jock? Let me know in the comment section. Hit the like button if you found this video informative. Subscribe to Technology Jock for more like this. Hit the bell icon as well. Thanks for watching. Ashwin Sundar here. Talk to you later. Bye.